हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द सेशन। इन दिस सेशन वी विल डिस्कस इंडियन पॉलिटिकल थॉट एंड द पर्सनैलिटी वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इज कबीर। फ्रेंड्स, वी ऑल नो कबीर एज अ मीडिएवल राइटर, मीडिएवल पोएट ऑफ इंडिया, एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू द जनरल ओपिनियन हिज थॉट्स वर बेसिकली बेस्ड अपॉन द लर्निंग द टीचिंग्स थ्रू द स्मॉल वर्सेस विच वी कॉल दोहास इन द हिंदी लिटरेचर। मोस्ट ऑफ अस नो कबीर फॉर दैट पर्पज ओनली, बट इन दिस सेशन आई विल आउटलाइन द वर्क्स ऑफ कबीर एंड द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ कबीर इन द पॉलिटिकल आइडियाज विच हैज बीन डेवलप्ड इन इंडिया ओवर द पीरियड ऑफ टाइम। So this session will focus on the political ideas of Kabir, which was a discourse of an alternative society. He points out the importance and the need for an alternative society then, which was actually existing at those time. Kabir's critique of state, the statecraft which was in practice at that time, particularly of judicial and revenue administration. So these are the, we can say, you may not heard of many things about the that Kabir have talked about the revenue administration or the how the state should work, and very important concept of Begumpura, which was actually, we can say, the counterpart of Gandhi's Ram Rajya. Begumpura was the utopia state as prescribed by the Kabir. So the political ideas of Kabir, which was a discourse of an alternative society of his time, Kabir's critique of state, judiciary, revenue administration, as I already told you, and the ideal village polity. As you all know, village has been the smallest identity of state in India. So whether the administration or the judiciary or anything arise from the village level. Okay, so according to Kabir also, the changes have to be made through the village level, whether it's a private property thing, whether justice, taxation, anything, it has to be taken from the village level. So the works of Kabir, if we talk about the life sketch and works of Kabir, there are many opinions about the lifetime period of which he lived about Kabir. But as a general opinion, it has been considered that he was a contemporary of Sikandar Lodi, and his life period lasts for more than a century, 1489 to 1517. He considered to be a resident of Banarasa, and it also reflects in his working. He made some references about the nearby places of Banaras, and he was a radical thinker. Think of someone who was counterpart with Basavanna, who was a thinker of 12th century in Karnataka. We can say these were the people who used to think 100 year or 200 year ahead of their time, whether Basavanna or the Kavi. But the difference is Basavanna is somewhat recognized thinker, but Kabir was not that much recognized for a very long period. He was recognized in, we can say, when the Hindi literature developed in 18th and 19th century, the Hajari Prasad Dwivedi, Ramchand Shukla, they made the study on Kabir, and from his works, which were actually the Adi Grantha, Panchvani, Sarvangi, Bijak and Granthavali. These are the, we can say, the academic discourse, comprise the writings of Kabir. Okay, so Basavanna was recognized, but it take a lot of time for the people to get the ideas of Kabir. Okay, what were his political ideas? Friends, question may be asked from you from various things. I have compiled the important points here. The discourse on the political ideas of Kabir needs to be think in the time of 14th and 15th century. If today someone says the patriarchies should be abolished, there should be equal status for the men and women, if someone used to say there should be a taxation free society, state free society, these points look very common to all of us. But think of the time when these were the 14th and 15th century. There was no one who can actually make a protest against the established procedure of the society. That is why there is an importance of Kabir, And that is why I was telling you that he used to think 100 or 200 years ahead of his time. Kabir himself was a worker. He himself was a vendor. He was a businessman. So he think about the various aspects of a society as a deliverer, and as a receiver. So he was critique to the feudal reaction and discrimination by the elite of the common masses. And his universal categories and monotheistic praxis, something which can do in practice. Okay, praxis is the word which is used for something which can be done by practice. So his universal categories and monotheistic praxis were intended to transcend the social divide. The social divide which was established in that period of time, he used to transcend from that social divide. Kabir was equally, in fact, more critical of the Jamindari system, as I told you, the feudal system, which beheld the traditional structure in pre-capitalist social formation. Okay, both Hindus and Muslims were the part of elite structure. So this was his complaint. It is not the religion or the caste which make the difference. Actually, it is the mindset of the people who found themselves over some line. So they start to behave likewise, whether they belong to any religion or any caste. Okay, both Hindus and Muslims were poor. Both Hindus and Muslims were rich, and they were part of the subalternity despite their religious differences. Religious victimization by elite did occur, but the economic position of the victims pulled them back to the society. So this is something to be considered. Now Begumpura was the utopian state of Kabir. He told about that. His consciousness and other worldliness were not separate from each other. There was no separation between a well-run administrative state or an utopian state. He says that these two things went concurrently, these two things went simultaneously. So the Begumpura, which was the reflection of the consciousness, the rebel ideas of Kabir, it was premised on a universal society without any economic or primordial differentiation. There should not be any differentiation between the people among themselves. And it was also, we can say, for the betterment of the society, for the poor and for those who were discriminated from the society. So he became the symbol of subversion and opposition to the parallel system which was established at his time. So these are the things which are very important for you to consider. And as I already told you, there is not much available about the political ideas of Kabir. But as I told you here, the stateless society, the utopian state, which do not differentiate between the common masses, the patriarchy thing, the taxation thing, the revenue administration thing, these are all important things about the Kabir. Since Kabir had not written anything, he was actually, we can say, illiterate. So he was not able to write anything. His discourses were, we can say, collected by his students. So Kabir became a symbol of his people, the Bani. And we can also say that this is the similarity between the Shrutis or Smritis, as we see in the Dharma Shastra or various religious Indian texts, which were evolved over the period of time. They were not written anywhere, but they were found somewhere from the Shrutis and Smritis. They were something which were remembered, they were heard of, and someone at later point of time has collected them and put them in a synchronized way so as to make people understand at a later period of time. So now some important questions which may be considered about this session. First one being the utopia of Kabir includes taxation as an implied feature of the governance. Yes, we cannot say, even though Kabir was illiterate and the taxation system at that period of time during the Mughals or Sultanate period have been evolved in India. So Kabir also understands that situation and provides his view on taxation in India. Okay. And he was of the opinion that a state should be a tax-free society. Second one, Kabir has been the only medieval thinker who criticized the established institution of patriarchy, governance, etc. We can say दिस क्वेश्चन डिपेंड्स अपॉन द ऑप्शंस व्हाट एवर यू गेट. कबीर इज बीइंग कंसिडर्ड एज इक्वली वी कैन से द क्रिटिक ऑफ द पैट्रियार्की एज बसवन्ना. सो ही वॉज नॉट द ओनली मिडीवल थिंकर बट इन द नॉर्दर्न पार्ट ऑफ इंडिया ही वॉज द only medieval thinker which have been found through his writings. The founders, we can say the people who worked on Kabir, they later on find out that he was actually ahead of his time. And he, if you have to point out a single man, considering his social class, considering his we can say the subaltern society in which he used to live, Kabir was the only one we can find in that position. So that's all for the session, friends. Thank you.